is one crime, people do not know the depth of trauma victims go through. I decided to take this walk because one, it is underreported. Two, nobody wants to face unpleasantness. People don't want to talk about it. Three, people need to know that things like this happen and a lot of people do not talk about it. Four, we also need to educate the populace on what to do if you are raped. Five, we need to tell the authorities to sit up, you know, and stand up to their responsibilities. And then we also need to protect ourselves, okay? Everybody is vulnerable. The impression that people say, somebody who know you can rape you, like, okay, you are partners before, like you are in a relationship with someone, how can that person rape you? After all, you guys have been having sex all this while. Rape is a crime that can be committed by anybody. I want to talk about victims now because the pain they go through, they don't talk about it. Now, when a victim falls into this category of victim, a lot happens to them. One, they shut out. They don't talk to people anymore. They don't trust you. They don't want to talk about you. They no more believe in themselves. Sometimes they blame themselves. Is it how I dressed? Was it what I said? Was it what I did this? But I'm here to say it is not about you. A victim is not to blame. In fact, you have no blame. You are blameless in this act because the person who did it because they wanted to do it. Okay, you did not entice that person to rape you. If you're talking about indecent dressing and all that, I call it babladash because infants are raped. I mean, men are raped too. Women are raped. There is this category of people that are strongly abused that we don't even talk about. These are the young men, our young men from the age of 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, you know, upwards are being abused by aunties, house helps, and people who are supposed to be taking care of them. I don't understand how mothers do not feel this pain with these children. And when they are done, they will still blame that child. Your body caused it. You're this one causing. I told you, don't wear this kind of clothes. Don't do this kind of hair. It's a lie. Anybody can be raped.
And the truth of the matter is, I will first of all say that rape didn't start today. But because we kept quiet all the while, it has become on the increase. So, but now that is like this, now we have decided to actually come up and create that awareness that we don't want it anymore. It's not a good thing, it's madness. I just can't fathom the fact that an adult will have his manhood up to rape a girl, or a lady will rape a boy, because it's both ways, however we want to look at it, to be honest. Rape is rape. As an adult, for God's sake, it is painful, let alone a little child that knows nothing, that is innocent. Look at the one that just happened and just been buried, my God. It could have been anybody's child. Enough is enough. Rape is evil. And whoever is caught doing that should be castrated. But unfortunately, we're in a country where that cannot happen. It's so unfortunate. But if that can be done, it will be so, so nice that it will be done. Because at the end of the day, even those at the top are also guilty. So let us all come together and in one voice, just like we have come out today, and say no. Once the person says no, screaming means no. No is no. It's not by force. If you're so interested in doing it, you can just use it and hit on the wall so that you will feel the pain that that little girl is going to feel, for God's sake. Please, I'm against it. There's not much talk to talk about today than to say no to rape. It is enough. And something just has to be done before it gets to our nephews and nieces.
If you have your kids in somebody's house, for instance, you have your child as somebody's house help, the person is there because you can't provide for your own child. So if your child gets raped, most times the parents know that the child was raped or is raped, but they can't help. They can't say anything, because if you say anything, you may not get favor from that person anymore. And most times people don't even get to believe you. Yes, and apart from that, apart from those helpless people who get raped, there are times when adults get raped, I think it's their fault most times. Okay, for instance, most of the adult people who talk about rape, for instance, a girl is collecting money from a guy, girls do it. You collect money from a guy, this guy has his own sisters, he has his family members he should spend money on, but he keeps spending money on you. The next thing, this guy invites you over to his house, and you have the mind to sleep in his house, and you don't want to do. And when the guy touches you, you start screaming rape. So now government should even look at these ones and say this one is not rape. You went to his house by yourself, you have been collecting his money, he's not your pastor that he should be conducting deliverance on you. So we should be able to differentiate types of rapes. Government should bring laws to punish those who rape. Most times when people rape, especially those ones who rape kids, because they are like their helpers. Those kids' parents would be able to do anything. But once the government comes into it, everybody will be aware that, okay, if you rape so-and-so person, if you rape, you'll be punished. And these are the kind of punishments you get for raping.
I have my friend who is even 40 watts now. She's not married. She has not had sex for whatever I know. I can't give her a name. Because she was raped at 9 years old. Not just her, not just by one person, her uncle, her cousins. And the day she ever said, the mother said, shut up, if you hear, I'm not taboo. So I am talking to mothers, you out there. How can you hide it? Because he's your brother, he rapes your daughter, and you say, don't say it. Rape is inhuman. You don't know the psychological trauma she goes through. I don't support rape. And today we say, no and no more to rape.
I mean, works like this are part of my little ways of, you know, showing support against, you know, rape. Because, I mean, rape is a big issue. And the more we begin to realize that it's a serious issue and not something that we should overlook, the more we begin to do something about it. I'm not sure the government is doing enough. My own opinion, I'm not sure.
What do you want them to do?
I mean, like I said, public punishment. When someone who rapes another person is being punished publicly and everyone can see what the government has done against it, then people begin to be scared about it. You know, people will be scared to rape other people. You know, but once they get away with it, because, I mean, we've seen several rape cases, we hear about it, they are doing something about it. Before you know, we don't hear about the offenders anymore. We don't even hear about the victim. Everything just goes under the carpet. And that's why it is continuous. And I mean, when I hear people say, it's the way ladies dress, if you wear short skirts, it doesn't make any sense to me, because you have your body. If you like walk on the street naked, I mean, you have no right to rape someone. It's your body. I mean, you can't tell a lady because she was wearing short. I mean, that's a lame excuse. Because you're wearing short skirts, you were dressed innocently, that's why I was moved and I had to rape you. Doesn't make any sense. So I mean, that's even out of the way.
As you can see, we are all out working and raging against rape. Rape is inimical, rape is harmful, rape deranges the mentality of anyone involved. A male can be raped, a female can be raped, but please, whoever that are victims of this should come out and speak for themselves, because we are fighting against rape. And I beseech everyone watching me today that you should support us. And also, make sure that rape is reduced to its minimum.
Men are not the only people that are possessed to rape. Like, I feel it's a sickness inside, so both sex parties are involved. So I believe guys can also be raped, and just as girls. I think there should be more punishment for rape.
It's becoming unbearable. Especially with the ones happening with our kids, our daughters, it's a very, very wicked act. They should help us see to it. They should set a particular punishment for rapists. It's high time they have to come out to fight for us. They should do that for us. It's nothing. It's actually nothing to them. Let them help us fight for this. Let them. Maybe I don't know. Maybe we should just castrate them. Yes, let's castrate them. It's not a problem. This is not just for men. Women too rape.
As you can see, I'm wearing a shirt called Perpetua.
Okay.
So this is a project that we are trying to embark on very soon, which tells a story about a young girl that was raped by her home lesson teacher.
Wow.
So yeah, and after a while, she had to go through a lot of trauma. You know, not until she was able to find a help in the hands of one of our sisters. So, you know, rape has become a reoccurrence, an event, which we think you should be able to cope, you understand, by all means. You know, that's why on our home way, we've been able to use the media in such a way that bringing it back into the movie. You know, these days we hardly see films that talks about rape and molestation or domestic violence. It's all about love and betrayal. Some people say some people are sick. It's not everybody that rape that they are sick. It's just like some people cannot just take their eyes off, you know, of anything they aren't scared, you understand? So I think by so doing this, I think we can be able to like let people realize that this is a very bad thing that we need to stop, and you know, let's just our voice be heard.
The bottlenecks with our laws, you know, and the rich can get away with it. You get a good lawyer. Some people are not really too keen on coming out to say, okay, I've been raped. Like the stigma that comes from the society. Then we also have our culture, which is the biggest impediment to people to talk out. Yeah. So these are the things that also hampers government, because we kind of take our culture is part of the government. So until we review our culture, we tweak it, then maybe we can say, okay, when things like this happen, it's no longer a stigma.
Well, I think we as ladies should learn to dress properly. I mean, this is not to excuse rape, but ladies should learn to dress properly. In decent dressing, to me, facilitates rape by like 30%. Facilitates rape by like 30%. And I think that people should come to understand that sex is actually a beautiful thing, and it should be left within the confines of marriage. As a journalist, I mean, who has been on this rape case for a while, I know that the government is actually not doing enough. We're talking that there's been a lot of protests, and the government doesn't seem to, I mean, be blinking an eyelid about it, be bathing an eyelid about it, really. I think the government is really not doing enough. Yeah, I mean, since this Ochaya case started, the government has really not made it a priority, you know, to look into it or to talk about it, except that I know that the police has been on the case and is currently on the case. So really, the government of Nigeria is not doing so much about the rape incidences in Nigeria. The men who rape infants, can I be honest? The men who rape infants need deliverance. Yes, they need prayers, they need deliverance, really.
This happened way back in uni. So I went to, this was when I was in 200 level. Yeah, so I went to a friend's house. This was the day before chemistry test. And so I went to a friend's house to study, just because he was kind of good in class. So I went to his house to study. I wasn't the only one there anyway. But, you know, everybody had gone. And then me, I stayed in the hostel, and the hostel was kind of nearby. So I said, okay, let me just take my time. And then as I was about to leave, stuff happened. But as I was about to leave, he tried to, you know, hold me down. And, you know, tell me that he told me that he had been liking me for some time now. And that was the opportunity. He had been liking me for some time, and you know, I haven't been giving him face. So he tried to, but I mean, I thank God things didn't go as planned. I was shouting my head off, I was screaming. Neighbors came, his friends, his guys came together, and they all laughed it off, but they allowed me to go. Like, they dragged me out of his room, and then, you know, they all started laughing. Like, when I was leaving, I heard laughter coming from the room. I mean, it was a very haunting experience. It was, till now, I still think, like, okay, what if anything had happened?